Madam First Lady, dear Mr. Trump, dear Mr. Secretary Pompeo, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear citizens of United States of America and the world, dear brave women of Afghanistan and brave women of the world, wherever you are fighting for the rights of women at this very every time. It's truly an honor to be with you today and the presence of so many amazing women leaders from Bolivia to Burkina Faso and from Syria to Malaysia. Before I even begin, I want to thank everyone around the world who have fought for women's empowerment. It was not so long ago that most women were considered property, and sadly, in some part of the world, it's still the same. Throughout the modern era, there has been one global leader in the fight for women's rights, and that's the United States of America. To the American people, to the American government, let me say thank you. Thank you for all of you have done to improve conditions for women around the world. Thank you for the honor to speak to you today on behalf of my fellow awardees. It's humbling to be honored today alongside heroes like Amina Kulani, Raita Nimpenga, and Emeya Coppens, whom were imprisoned for their activism. Heroes like Lucy Kocharyan, and who launched a movement against sexual harassment in Armenia. Heroes like Jalila Haidar, who despite threats has worked tirelessly to protect ethnic minorities in Pakistan. My name is Zarifa Ghaffari. Actually, I'm not a hero. I'm just the mayor of Maidan Shahr, a city in southern side of capital. It's a conservative place, a place where men aren't used to seeing women in position of authority, a place where some men resist women in authority. When I start my job, the men at the municipal office refused to acknowledge me and my authority. A mob came and chased me away. They thought that was the end of that. But I came back. I came back and I stood my ground. A few years ago, I would not have expected that they would ever hear me and my voice. Now I'm even listened and to be treated with full of respect. In the news, the women of Afghanistan are often seen as victims, and it is true that women have been bearing the brunt of war. But we have other stories to tell about women who fought and fighting for their rights and do not give up. Like example, in the 1920s, Soraya Tarzi became the queen consort of Afghanistan. It was about the time when women here in the United States achieved an amendment of the Constitution that granted them the right to vote. Soraya campaigned for women's rights and education. I have no nostalgia for monarchy, but Soraya was a role model. I think of her whenever I'm frustrated. And when people tell me, give up Zarifa, leave this office, stay at home, take care of your family matters. Whatever we women of world may have already achieved, let us not take it for granted. It could be taken back from if we are not vigilant and strong. When I walk around in Wardak province, I know that other girls and women look at me and definitely will say, I am smart, why I can do whatever Zarifa is doing? I'm sure they will definitely say. I would like to thank the United States of America And the Afghan government, especially respected President Dr. Mohammad Ashraf Ghani and his wife, respected Ms. Rula Ghani, for standing with our women and for taking women empowerment seriously. It can contribute to peace and stability. Women of my generation have not forgotten the reign of the Taliban, and we are, as always, worried for the future. Therefore, let me ask for your continued support to ensure that Afghan peace process does not erase the gains that have been made since the dark days of the Taliban regime. Good luck, love, and respect to all of you. Remember us, and God bless you all.